Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. We're across the pond in England this week, and two teams are hoping to show off for an international audience. It's the Texans going up against the Black Knights.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Houston Texans and the London Black Knights. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a good effort on the return there gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Just short of the 45 at the 44. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down. Another fine carry from the NFL's rushing leader, and quarterbacks typically dominating the MVP balloting, but I think you got to give this guy serious consideration, don't you?
I agree totally. I mean, he's leading the league in rushing, and let's face it, partner, the running back renaissance in the NFL, it's real, and it's really helping teams along the way. He's a prime example. Got to give him strong consideration for MVP talk. Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Here we go now. Blue Landon.
He'll look to throw. Pressure comes and down he goes. So a first quarter sack, and remember, keep in mind, he had two sacks in last week's game.
And it's always intriguing to me to watch these great pass rushers, because some of them, they need their teammates to scheme for them, maybe occupy people, make it a one-on-one matchup. Other guys, they just defeat everything in front of them. To get two sacks in a game, it's a little bit of both for you.
Here as he'll get it to the 11, maybe the 12-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. The hookup on the right side to Hopkins. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On first down, he'll drop to throw, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch at 2nd and 8. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
This defense now can make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
They're going to look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. And he's got room! And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
And he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They go play action here on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll make this a second and long. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And incomplete there, a nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it was real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Let's go! Green, 39! Green, gone, gone! Over! Here we go now!
Now they try the right side here. And he gets it down to the 32. Call it a gain of five. Fourth down now. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
After the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here.
They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about 4.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon as it's long. 6 yards to go here on 2nd down. A handoff as they run the counter play. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll lead here to a 3rd down. They'll drop the throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. And now out comes Houston. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best.
Put your foot on the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
On 2nd down, they'll try and run the counter. Oh, he's got some breathing room. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. And they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack, and on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. They only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. They'll look to throw. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Jayon Brown with a big-time sack on 3rd down. And it'll be a loss of 7. The Texans send the punter out as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. Taking it about the 16. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And possession will switch hands. 1st and 10. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And this is their 3rd drive. Maybe the focus right now not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a 2nd drive, no 1st down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that 1st one up?
And he'll get this up only to about the 33.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Play action. They'll throw. Going deep for Hopkins. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. He'll look to throw here. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Yeah, he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this will be taken at the 13. He had one man to beat. It takes a touchdown saving tackle to bring him down. And the Texans with great field position to start this drive as they take over first and 10. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Here we go now.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he gets it down to the 32. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Second and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard. Two minutes remain here in the first half. My good friend Charles and I right back at you after this. And the D looking like they may blitz. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about 4 more for a first. Set up to throw. And this is caught at the 8. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Green, 39.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Back there, not Philly. Here we go. Set.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. This offense so far on third down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. They're looking at a third and goal here. And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. A great effort there as the first half is winding down. And the Texans will add on to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. So far, they've had three drives, three punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, three punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. They'll throw now on the final play. Going for the deep ball. This is intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. Now, my apologies, Larry. I wanted to hear the report. Somebody's in a hurry, so we're going to get him right to quarter number three. And from down in Miami, an update. The Dolphins have added on, and they seem to be pulling away in that one. We'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. And here now the offense heading back out there. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what do we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Throw now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
To throw now on second and 10. Buying time to his left. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And they will finally get him down as he's all the way to the 36-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They are excited about where they are in this game.
They run the counter now on first down. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall at the 36. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down. Lucky 56. Here we go.
toss. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. He lost six there on the first down play.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Complete to Stewart, right side. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56. Set, green.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So put another 3 on the board. And all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the third quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive.
Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Anthony Barr in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. Now back to throw. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on 3rd.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on 4th. And he goes in motion here in the backfield.
Hot! Hot! Hot!
Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on 4th down. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. Punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because
rush coming, and he's taken down.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Throw here out of the gun, and the pressure gets to him again. Jayon Brown in there to get him his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
So Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Let's take it inside his own 40. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also...
Welcome back now here in London. As we've got the final quarter upon us, we get ready to start the fourth. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down. A handoff as they run the counter play. And some room to roam now. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A big run there, 29 yards at a first.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continued.
Touchdown, Houston! A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Texans turn that interception into a touchdown.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. Throw here on second and 10. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Well, when you start thinking of guys that are in the mix for Defensive Player of the Year, I think you use him as Exhibit A. Maybe he's not the leading guy right now, but he's at least on the periphery and deserves to be in the discussion.
And because of that, he's looking at a game today where, in order to make that big move and maybe become the guy, he needs multiple takeaways, multiple big plays, things that get our attention and reverberate for weeks to come.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. I think this defense tired of seeing him run the football, and this D-line probably getting sick of the O-line as well.
And as I'm watching this, I'm thinking about a conversation I had with Adam Gase, the head coach of the Miami Dolphins in the offseason. He told me that he asked his running backs.
And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. A great effort there. A 16-yard touchdown run. And the Texans use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. And they're able to up the lead by one more. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And to give this time to the tailback. It's a loss of 10 yards on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Well, that wasn't just a loss. That was a loss of big yardage there. So the sense you're starting to get is that offensively, things are starting to pile up against them. And they've got to find a way to stop that.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at about the 31. And he'll take this back down inside the 20. Yet another interception.